Yo, 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 hello guys, and welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to Madden 20 Subscriber League, and this is it. Today is the big day. The playoffs have begun, and we are starting with the Los Angeles Chargers taking on the Houston Texans. Now, for the Chargers, it's going to be one subscriber who tries to put the rest of the team on his back. He is the only subscriber on the Chargers, former New York Giants quarterback, Rylan Brown. He made it to the NFC Championship in year number one when he played for the Giants, lost to the Bears, and has been in LA ever since. Rylan Brown, the 27-year-old, looking to do it. Now, moving over to Houston, you got Alex Perez running back. You also have Chance Hartsell at quarterback. And I believe that would be it for subscribers on Houston. So, not that many subscribers on these teams, but there are some. And they're about to battle it out right now here in the wild card round. In this episode, we'll have two games. This is kind of like the part one of wild card, because every team basically has a subscriber on it. So, it'd be 2nd and 7 later in the game, as the Chargers would be the first team to cross the 50-yard line right there. 3rd and 8 after that handoff there, and these two teams talking to each other. Rylan Brown would then step back on the next play. He'd have all day to throw it. He would throw it finally down to his running back, who would end up picking up the first down and extending the drive. That's a big pickup right there. And really needed as well. Here we go. Later in the drive, 2nd and 6. Hand up. Up the middle. He's got room. And then gets hit. And it brought down inside the 3. Make it the 2-yard line. That's 7. 7-0. Houston would then have the ball later in the game. Pushing against, you know, the Chargers in their territory here. Trying to get inside the red zone. It would be 3rd down and 3. Chance Hartsell. This is another subscriber quarterback. He's fairly new to the series and new to the league. Haven't heard too much of him. He would dump it off to Alex Perez, who would break a tackle and put on the Jets, picking up the first down on 3rd down and very needed. 2nd and 10 now. Shotgun formation. Chance Hartsell throws it. Guy open. He gets hit, fumbles the ball, and the Chargers would pick it up. They're still going there. Nice run after the fumble recovery right there. After that, the Chargers would have the ball. They take it all the way across to the other side in their red zone. And, they're 2nd and 5 on the 9-yard line. Rylan Brown would hand it off to his superstar X-Factor running back, who I'm actually not too sure who that is. It's, there's his name right there at the top. 14 rushes for him. It looked like it said 70 yards. Might be wrong. I'm not too sure. Another handoff, though. This time it gets shut down and sets up a 2nd and goal. See what happens here. So far, a very big start for the Chargers. Another handoff, and he's getting pushed back. They blow the whistles, and that'll set up a 3rd and goal. Single back formation the Chargers come out in. See what happens here. It's a pass, Rylan Brown, but it has no time. Gets ripped down right away, and they'll have to settle for a field goal. That's exactly what they would do, but later in the game, Houston would finally have another shot. Last time, we all know what happened. Well, they fumbled the ball here. They really need to get some points on the board here late in the 3rd quarter. It'd be 10-0. Chance Hartsell, what can he do here? He's going to keep it, throws the slant. I believe that might have been the same guy who fumbled it earlier. He would hold on to it this time, though. And they're just a yard short for making this a 3-point game. So here we go. 1st and goal. Chance Hartsell. Hand off the middle. Alex Perez, subscriber running back, goes right up the middle and gets his team on the board for the first time here late in the 3rd. That's exactly what they needed. Now, later in the game, we'd do a little bit of simming, and the Chargers would drive right back down the field. And they're 2 yards away from making this 17-7. There's just been no answer for the Houston's defense. Ryland Brown would step back. Pressure coming. He would chunk it deep into the back of the end zone. It's broken up. And, wow. Had a chance to go up 17-7 there. Now it's third and goal. Houston trying to make a goal line stop. Another, but they'll miss out on it. The slant gets them. And the Chargers, they pass it again. And that time it works. Finding Anderson in the back of the end zone on the slant. Number 48 just couldn't keep up. And make it 17-7. So later simming it, though, the Houston would drive down the field. It's got about 8 minutes and some change left in the fourth quarter. They are inside the red zone here in the wild card round. They need to get something going as it's 17-7. And this handoff here by Alex Perez would definitely get them where they need to go, 6 yards away now. Second and inches. He didn't pick up the first down, but he was close. Let's see what happens here. Chance Hartsell. Pressure's coming. And he gets brought down, and that's going to set up a 3rd and 7. Now, if you're Houston, you could take a field goal here if you trust your defense. And we'll see if that's what happens here. But they're thinking end zone. It's a pass clearly. Oh, but he gets cracked, and that's not going to be enough. So now that's the question. What do you do here? And I would assume you take the field goal. That's exactly what they would end up doing. It would go right down the middle, making it 10-17. So here we go. Shotgun formation. Handoff, no play action. It's thrown, broken up, almost intercepted, all in one. Wow. Here we go. Shotgun formation once again for LA. See what he does here. He's going to throw it to the sideline. Close to the sideline anyways, but that gets stopped short. And Houston will get the ball back. I'm going to take a sip of my coffee here really quickly. And they would be in field goal range. Oh, this could end the game, in my opinion. And it's up, and it's good. I think that's the dagger. I think LA is moving on. Now, simming it later into the game, the Houston would get right back into the red zone. Matter of fact, they'd be on the 7-yard line, and we have to watch it because technically it's not over. Chance Hartsell would buy time and then chunk that one away in the backfield there and set up 2nd and goal. What do they do here? It's going to be another pass. Chance Hartsell. He had time. You just got to get rid of it quicker than that. And now it's not looking really good. They don't call a timeout. They're trying to save all the timeouts for defense. Chance Hartsell. End zone. Most intercepted is what it is. And now it's 4th down. So playoff hopes are on the line right here for Houston. They're actually going to settle for the field goal, try and get end zone, which means they have to get into the end zone if they can get the ball here on this onside kick. They can't settle for another field goal. And we all know how the onside kicks go in Madden. I don't think I've ever seen one work. Not on Madden 20. And that's it. Ryland Brown carries the Chargers through the wild card, and they'll be heading to the divisional round. So congratulations to LA. So here we go. Next game, we got the Minnesota Vikings taking on the Super Bowl losers of year number 2, I do believe, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And this is going to be a good one, boys. I'm excited. This is... What the heck are those? What is Tampa Bay wearing? I've never seen that before. I didn't change the uniforms. I guess this is a playoff special. White helmets. That's weird. But yeah. This game, unlike the first game of the video, this game has a lot of subscribers on both sides. And, well, two very, very successful teams. The other two teams were not as successful as the two teams we're about to watch. Minnesota finishing 12-4, I do believe. And, of course, Tampa Bay being a Super Bowl loser team. I mean, that's still pretty impressive. In year number two, they made it to the Super Bowl. So, of course, you have Drayton Glendening, Lloyd Graham at tight end there. Well, this is he'll be at tight end. You got Malachi. That's a subscriber as well, wide receiver. Craig Owlers at running back. So, yeah, there's Lloyd Graham. There it is, tight end. 86 overall, 27. Yeah, this is the squad that made it to the Super Bowl in year number two, and they ended up losing. But not only that, they do have a guy they didn't have back then. It's a rookie subscriber, and that, my friends, is rookie Jerry Shepard. Free safety, 22 years old, 90 overall. He brings a whole nother skill level and asset to this team that they didn't have back in year number two. They have it here in year number four, and they're looking for another playoff Super Bowl run. So we'll see if they can get past the Minnesota team, who has Casey Woods, Rico Mayo Jr., these two guys that lead this offense. But it's really the wide receiver core that you got to be scared of. Brian Watson, Alex Harnish, and Tyler Higbinson. They are the best wide receiver core in the league. As far as subscribers go, they dominate every single year. So that is the team. No subscribers on Minnesota's defense. And we have one subscriber on Tampa Bay's defense. And right off the rip, it's Craig Owlers with the catch. Dude, these unis look so weird. I just don't know what is going on right now. But second and six. Drayton Glendening once again going to Greg Allers, who did not catch that. He dropped it. Third and eight now, or third and six. Drayton Glendening will keep it here. And he steps into the pocket, shoots it deep into the end zone, but way out of bounds. I liked how he stepped inside the pocket, though. He's showing that he's not scared to stay in there. And, dude, I'm sorry, but excuse me, man. Whoa. These uniforms, though, man, they are just, they are something else. Yeah. Tampa Bay would go up by three, though. Let me do something really quickly here. So here we go. Later in the drive, for Minnesota's first opening drive, it'd be a 26-yard reception to Brian Watson. A guy we've all heard of here recently, as he just got into it with Zach Keister. And they had their little beef. And now they're in the playoffs. Could possibly meet into the playoffs if Minnesota wins this game. Second and nine, though, for their opening drive. Casey Woods would step back. Has time. Throws it to the sideline to none other than, I do believe, Brian Watson. So third and four, though, would be the call here. We'll see what happens. Casey Woods steps back, goes down the middle to another subscriber. Or that actually might, is that the tight end? Not too sure there, number 86. Yeah, that's the tight end. Never mind, that's not a subscriber. But still, this Minnesota's wideout core is deep, my friends. First and goal. Hand off to Rico Mayo Jr., and this is the guy who can open it up for Minnesota's passing game, because he's a very talented running back as well. He's definitely in my top five for running backs. Second and goal. Casey Woods slant. That's a pass right there, and that's definitely a subscriber wide receiver. Is it Alex Harnish or Tyler Higbinson? It looks like it was Tyler Higbinson with the catch. So, again, that depth is really, oh my gosh. The extra point was freaking blocked. And Minnesota luckily picks it up and gets brought down immediately. It's not a four-point game. It's a three-point game. And then later in the drive, Tampa Bay would have the ball. Cross the 50-yard line. Drayton Glendening passes it to Craig Allers, who, whoa! Did you guys just see what Craig Allers just did to Minnesota's defense? These poor guys just got embarrassed. Watch. Oh, my God. He took both. They're just falling over each other. It's so embarrassing. And now Tampa Bay takes the lead 10-6 here in the playoffs. Handoff going to the left side here. No, that's not going to work. Gets brought down immediately. So here we go, 3rd and 8. Casey Woods steps back. Going deep. Guy wide open. The ball gets ripped out by Jerry Shepard, it might have been. That's Alex Harnish. What's the call on the field right now? It's a reception, but not a touchdown and not a fumble. Look at this. Oh, my gosh. He catches it. He's definitely out of bounds. Did he cross the pylon? Wow, what a freaking play, guys. This is a good game. I can already feel it. First and goal for Minnesota. Handed off to Rico Mayo. No, they're going to keep it. Mayo. Casey Woods throws it away. Didn't like what he's seen there, and now it's 3rd and goal. 6-10. What a game. Here we go. Casey Woods stepping back, throwing it. Touchdown, Minnesota. There it is. Alex Harnish with the catch. So later in the game, 3rd and 8, Buccaneers would try and keep their drive alive, but it wouldn't work as it's getting close to halftime, 13-10. Tampa Bay is definitely the underdogs in this game. They didn't have as good of a season as Minnesota did, but we all know it doesn't matter about what you've done in the past. If you've made it to the playoffs, you've punched your ticket, and that's all that matters. It's all getting laid down on the line here today for both of these teams. So, we'll see. I mean, this is a close game. Tampa Bay could possibly go down by 6 here right before halftime if this kick is good. We've seen one get blocked already, but this one doesn't, and it goes right down the middle, make it 16-10. So here we go. Later in the third quarter, the Vikings would have the ball right back. 3rd and 2, Rico Mayo Jr., 7 yards, another 7-yard rush, and now it's time to hop in because, well, they're getting too close. I don't want to miss anything. So 2nd and 3, Casey Woods. This is a big drive for Minnesota because they can actually control this game a little more if they can just finish this drive. We'll see what happens here. 3rd and 2, shotgun formation. Casey Woods, man in motion. It's going to be a hand, no play. Play fake. It's right up the middle. He's going inside the 10. They catch Tampa Bay off guard. That was a trick play, and it was the first time they ran it. A fake handoff to the wide receiver in motion, then handoff to Rico Mayo, and that was a really smart play right there. I like that. Casey Woods steps back. Oh, pressure's coming. He gets hit as he went to go throw it. Luckily, he doesn't fumble it. Nice pressure right there by Ryan. Gets in there and gets the quarterback. So 2nd and goal now. See what happens here. Looks like it's going to be a run, and that's exactly what it is, and it gets stuffed. Nowhere to go for Mayo. 3rd and goal. He's going to keep it, throws it, and I mean, I don't know what they were expecting right there with that. They will get stopped to a field goal, and that is right there. That's Jerry Shepard, the hard-hitting beast. And they would settle for another field goal. This one would go up and good, and now it's 19-10. Late in the third, a handoff here to Craig Allers, who's trying to make some room on 1st and 15. He can make it 2nd and 10, and Tampa Bay, they need to keep this offense rolling as Minnesota's done exactly that. You got to hang with them. And you cannot give up a no-score possession right here, in my opinion. Let's see what they can do. 3rd and 8. Great time, Glendinning. Wide open! Just couldn't break the tackle, but hey, they're fine with that right there. He was wide freaking open. 2nd and 13. It would be a pass caught, and now Tampa Bay. Man, Minnesota's struggling. I believe Tampa Bay, their record is an 8-8 record. I think. I'm pretty sure. I may be wrong, but I don't know. Minnesota shouldn't be struggling against a team like Tampa Bay. But they exactly are. Now, they do get a stop, though. Does Tampa Bay go for it, though? They're probably going to kick a extra point or field goal here. Make it 13 to 19. So, we'll see. And oh, my God. It's Marcus Turner. I think that's... No, they went for it on 4th and 2 to the tight end, Marcus Turner, who caught the ball in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Are you freaking kidding me? And the extra point's good. 19-17. We have ourselves a freaking ball game, boys. Holy crap. Tyler Higginson with a 12-yard reception. And he's driving down the field with his offense. Fourth quarter's got 10 minutes and some change left. 2nd and 6. We got to hop into this game here. Shotgun formation. Here we go. Minnesota has the ball. Casey Woods, handoff, delayed handoff. Barely got the handoff off as Mayo goes down immediately. 3rd and 10 now. Tampa Bay, could they steal this from Minnesota? Oh, man, this is... We're going to find out. Casey Woods, he steps back. He throws it. Mayo, he can't close the distance. Mayo shows the speed. And first down. 45 could just have closed that distance, but he couldn't catch up. Mayo was just too quick for him. And now it's 1st and 10. Minnesota has the ball. It's going to be a handoff here. And Mayo's got more room on the left side. 2 times in a row now. He's just darted off. And it's now... 2nd and 1 here. Minnesota, quick pass right there. Oh, that goes backwards. Not the best call. Setting up now, 3rd and 4. See what happens here. 3rd and 4. Casey Woods steps back, throws it. It's caught. Is that a first down? I don't know. He looks short to me, and he is short. Good tackle by Bradshaw right there. And that'll set up a field goal here. And one has been blocked. Remember that. Is this one? Nope. This one's not blocked, and it goes right down the middle, making it 22-17. So 2nd and 5. Handoff, Craig Allers right up the middle. Spins. Breaking tackles. Face mask, clearly. And that is going to set Tampa Bay up in good field position later in the game. About 5 minutes and some change left. Tampa Bay would be 5 yards away from the end zone. Touchdown here takes the lead. They cannot settle for a field goal. Breton Glendinning steps back. Throws it. Craig Allers. What can he do? No, he doesn't do anything. He gets dropped immediately. 2nd and goal. It is all on the line here, boys. Playoff football. And we could see an upset here if Tampa Bay can finish this drive. Breton Glendinning, he steps back. He's throwing it into the back of the end zone. And it's dropped. He had it in his hands, and he freaking dropped it. Oh, my goodness. Drayton Glennon, he steps back on 3rd and goal. He throws it. It's caught. Malachi, oh, my God. And he pushes his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. How did he just do that? That wasn't Malachi. That was Covington. My bad. I thought that was just going to be a routine check down. He gets tackled. It was the key block that did it. Number 24 blocked that one dude. And then, of course, Covington did truck 2 guys at once. I'm not trying to take anything from him. He did truck and force his way in there. So here we go, 22-25. Casey Woods trying to drive down the field. He gets across the 50. Still plenty of time, unfortunately. Well, I'm not going to say unfortunately. I'm not biased here. There's a lot of time here for him to actually take the win. Now, do realize a field goal would tie it and send this game into overtime. Casey Woods up the middle, and it's caught, dude. Wow, what a catch. First and 10. They're already, in my opinion, in field goal range, as long as they don't go backwards. They're looking for the win, though. Casey Woods, shotgun formation. Steps back, throws it. It's caught. Brought down. Getting them closer to that field goal. Here we go. Casey Woods steps back. Has time. Throws it. Dumped down once again. He's being safe here. And that's smart as Rico Mayo Jr. fights and gets the first down. 2-minute warning goes off. 3 points separate these two. Casey Woods steps back. Throws a guy wide open. Gets brought down. And oh no, first and goal, Minnesota could win this. Casey Woods, go in, end zone, it's caught, no! There's a flag, he had stepped out of bounds. His foot was out of bounds, which is actually a penalty. So set them back a little farther. They're still at the 2-yard line, so I'm not too sure, I guess. I don't know. But anyways, here we go, man in motion, second and goal. Casey Woods. Keeps it, gets hit as he throws it, bounces off the goal there, and then incomplete. So third and goal is now the situation here. It's going to be a handoff. Mayo gets brought down by Jerry Shepard short. Oh, my goodness. Jerry Shepard, subscriber, strong safety, just saved the Buccaneers from losing this game. Minnesota will go for the tie. As long as it's not blocked! Holy crap, that was almost blocked. I don't know if you guys seen that. It went in, it's good, and it's tied up 25-25. Here we go. So later in overtime, Minnesota would have the ball. And they would drive down the field with a big catch right there. Setting them, they're kind of out of field goal range a little bit, especially for Madden. And this right here would not help them at all. It'd be an even harder field goal if they were to try and do it from here. So second and 12. All they need, though, is a couple yards and they could win this game. Field goal doesn't win it, though. They do gotta actually score, though. So we'll see what happens here on third and 8. Shotgun formation. Casey Woods takes the snap, throws it, going deep down the field. It's Brian Watson. The biggest catch of this man's career in overtime. And now the game is in their hands. They should win this one. Brian Watson, wow, what a freaking catch. What a route. He got wide open, cut through that defense like it was butter. And now it's first and goal. And Tampa Bay's upset is looking, well, it's looking like it's going to be a lot harder. As a matter of fact, it's over. Because Brian Watson just ended it with that touchdown catch. I changed my mind. That right there is the biggest catch of that man's career. An overtime catch in the playoffs to send your team to the divisional round. So here are the stats on the day. Rico Mayo, he had a good game, 117 yards. Tyler Higbinson, Alex Harnish, Brian Watson, all of them had phenomenal games, splitting three touchdowns between the three of them. And I feel bad for this guy right here, Jerry Shepard, played his heart out with 11 tackles, and he's going home. I hope you guys enjoyed it. That's going to be it for this episode. And as always, if you enjoyed the video, make sure to smash that like button. I hope you guys have a great day. And until next time, I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.